Tejinder Ladi Singh and welcome to Pastel Passion. So last time I said something about sharing my experience with different oil pastels with you. I have been frequently asked about the brand of oil pastels that I use, its pros and cons. So in this video, I'll compare two brand of oil pastels with you. One is the Sennelier, which I have been using for quite some years now. It's a French brand and considered to be the best in the market in this category, and justifiably expensive too. The other one is the Gallery from Mungyo. It's a Korean brand and I only recently tried it. My last painting In Deep Waters was made using Gallery oil pastels. Apart from this video, if you want to feel the difference between these two brand of oil pastels, you may watch my earlier videos. My last video, the last artwork that I did, In Deep Waters, was made using Gallery oil pastels, and all other artworks, the earlier ones, were made using Sennelier oil pastels. Sennelier oil pastels, a box set of 48 color sticks, costs around 5200, while Gallery Artist soft oil pastels, a box of 48 color sticks, costs around 1500. Now you do the maths and you'll find the difference is about 350% plus. So let's get on and see if we can justify this price difference.
I'll start with some swatches of colors from both the brands. So I've taken only those colors which match to each other from both the brands. The first row is from Sennelier. Try not to do that. Now swatches from Gallery soft oil pastels.
So you can see that the Sennelier pastels are much more rich in terms of vividness and brightness. I'm not taking into consideration the swatches or the colors that did not match up between the two brands, so I've crossed out those. Now even after rubbing out or blending out the colors with fingers, we can clearly see that the vividness or brightness of Sennelier colors remain intact. The Gallery colors are relatively dull. Let's do some more blending exercises. We'll start with the red family. Fallouts or scrapings is another issue with Gallery oil pastels. You can clearly see that the Sennelier oil pastels have much more rich color pigmentation as compared to Gallery oil pastels. Let's meet the green family now. Thank you.
very certainly the gallery oil pastels are much more opaque, but they lose out on brightness and the vividness part. While we are on it, let's check out the blue family too. Once again, the opaqueness in the gallery oil pastels is quite good, but the pigmentation, the brightness, the vividness is relatively much less. Next, let's try the color on color abilities of these pastels. Sennelier oil pastels, being oily, are easily applicable over another layer of color, and they spread easily too. Now, in case of gallery oil pastels, I found it hard to put one color over another. That's probably because they are hard bound, less oily, less creamier. Applying more pressure only led to ruining the base layer. Well, if you are using gallery oil pastels, it would be advisable that you clear out these small bits and pieces, scrappings falling out from the stick, before you go on to blend the color. Okay, now let's see how these oil pastels behave with a brush. We'll start with the Sennelier oil pastel. You can use the brush to take the color directly from the pastel stick. Else, you can scoop out the color from the stick with a knife and then use the brush on the knife. Or even you can apply the color directly onto the canvas or paper and then blend it with a brush. It will all depend on how fine the work you are going to do will be. I found it hard to put the gallery oil pastels onto the brush. While the Sennelier oil pastels latched onto the brush very generously. And the difference is right there on your screen. Working with oil pastels on an oil sheet or a canvas with a brush using an oil medium was okay with both the brands, except for the fact that Sennelier could cover more area and with less effort. It was very thoughtful of Sennelier to have given perforations for easy tearing of the wrapper as the stick gets used up. So at least I found it practically very convenient. Otherwise, well, you can see how tedious a job can be tearing a wrapper. The knife glides smoothly on the Sennelier oil pastel, and the application is equally smooth. And on this gallery oil pastel, you can see the jerks. Okay, so now let's summarize what we have seen and done so far. Sennelier clearly has rich color pigmentation and hence more vividness and brightness in the colors as compared to gallery oil pastels. Color on color, definitely again Sennelier scores better than gallery. gallery colors are much more opaque when compared on a single layer factor, but that is because they have less oil, but it doesn't hold good for the layering properties. The coverage factor, again, since Sennelier pistols are much more oily, they cover more area as compared to gallery. Definitely, you can use a brush easily and effectively with Sennelier oil pistols, while with gallery, it's a strict no-no. Knife work in Sennelier oil pistols is like a knife through butter. Can't say the same about gallery oil pistols. Stroking is easy and much more effective with Sennelier oil pistols as compared to gallery. Perforations in the wrapper by Sennelier provides for easy peeling, and I very strongly endorse it as a great convenience. Use of brush and oil medium with oil pistols on oil sheet or canvas works well in case of Sennelier, and relatively less effective, less coverage in case of gallery oil pistols. Sennelier has about 120 shades on offer, which includes about 10 iridescent colors. Gallery has about 38 less shades, a library of 82, which consists of 12 iridescent colors. Now lastly, but definitely not the least, the pricing. Sennelier oil pistols cost more than 3 times that of gallery oil pistols. And a downside of Sennelier oil pistols is that they do not dry on their own. You will need a fixative for that, and Sennelier does have the right one for it. Now obviously the question arises whether Sennelier is worth its cost. Well, there's nothing new to say about Sennelier oil pistols than what has already been said. But anyhow, to add to what has already been covered, and what I believe you should know is that Sennelier oil pistols were designed especially for Picasso in 1949. Picasso wanted a medium that he could hold in his hands and use freely on a variety of surfaces, on paper, on canvas, on metal, ceramic, glass, wood, without fading or cracking. And that is how Sennelier oil pistols were born. All these qualities in Sennelier oil pistols allow for a great deal of freedom in pictorial expression. Needless to say, they are worth every penny paid for. Still though, they could be heavy on your pocket, so to make it easy for you to take an option, I would say if you are a beginner, amateur, you could go with gallery oil pistols. With time, once you get a hang of this medium and you feel the need to step up and go professional, you can always opt for Sennelier oil pistol. I really hope this video helps you clear some, if not all, the doubts that you had on this subject. If you have any questions which need to be clarified on this subject, I would be most happy to answer them. Thank you, have a nice day, and take good care of yourself.